People have known that there's information about their health in their DNA, but we're going to go beyond genetics. We're going to really incorporate a holistic look at things that affect your health and your wellness and bring these to customers as regular insights.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome the Vice President, Ancestry Health, Sarah South.
Thank you for welcoming me to Silicon Slopes 2020. It's exciting to be here, so many invigorating ideas, and we've got like the greatest snow on earth falling outside, creating a little bit of traffic havoc, but it's also bringing here together some of the greatest tech on earth. I'm Dr. Sarah South, Ancestry Health Vice President, and for the next 10 minutes, I hope to take you on a journey. It's actually three journeys that converge here in Utah. My professional journey, the journey of personalized medicine, and Ancestry's journey to preventative health. All three journeys are made possible thanks to the innovation, the ingenuity, and the pioneering spirit that we find here in Utah. And so, I want to briefly explore these converging journeys together on a lift ticket to preventative health. At Ancestry, we empower journeys of discovery. We move from summit to summit, using genetic and technology together to help people understand more about their roots. Ancestry began as a tech startup over three decades ago here in Utah, with the goal to revolutionize how people understood their origins. Not only has Ancestry succeeded in this regard, we've also become the world's leader in consumer genomics and are empowering millions on their journeys. But let's start with my own personal professional journey. It all began with sheep butts. The barns and the pastures that house the sheep at Utah State University may look idyllic in that mountain setting in Cache Valley, but make no mistake, those barns are housing some innovative genetic laboratories. And my training in genetics started at Utah State University, where as an undergraduate, I worked in the laboratory of now President Dr. Noelle Cockett at USU. There we studied high-value genetic traits in sheep, including this trait of beautiful buttocks, also known as calopige. You can see that sheeps 1 and 3 have much better behinds than their siblings 2 and 4. They have 30% more muscle and less fat on the same diet. This is a profitable trait for the sheep industry and a genetic trait we might all want to have. Even as an undergraduate, I was allowed to be directly involved in this research. It was an invaluable experience and solidified my desire to pursue a career in genetics. But I decided to switch from sheep to humans and went to Johns Hopkins School of Medicine, where I pursued a PhD. But while at Hopkins, on the other side of the country, I learned about a fundamental event in the history of medical genetics that happened back here in Utah, at Alta Ski Resort, a place I often visit. In December of 1984, the US Department of Energy brought together a group of geneticists at Alta with the goal to develop new techniques to identify mutations in humans. You look at the list of attendees, and it was really a who's who in medical genetics, including many distinguished faculty members at the University of Utah. Many of these geneticists had not worked together. They knew of each other, but they did not really work as colleagues yet. And a few of them were skeptical about the goals of the meeting. But fortunately, they were socked in with powder for 5 days. The meeting went long because of the great snow. And so they spent additional time together on the slopes and in the conference rooms and agreed that it was insufficient to just identify human mutations. In order to really understand the clinical importance, they would need to sequence and catalog the entire human genome, and not just from one person, but from many people across many populations. And so this became the most productive meeting of these geneticists' career, because it was the founding of the Human Genome Project, an international project that has laid the foundation for personalized medicine today. And many of those first human samples that were fully sequenced came from Utah families. So since Utah is the birthplace of personalized medicine, it has always felt like a home for me professionally. And after finishing my training at Hopkins, I returned to Utah, and as a faculty member at the University of Utah and a medical director at ARUP Laboratories, I led a clinical diagnostics team that looked at the DNA of hundreds of thousands of patients with various disorders. There were cardiovascular abnormalities, neurological abnormalities, and cancer. We looked at the DNA to see if we could identify the source of the illness and any personalized medications. The work was cutting edge and very gratifying. We were using the power of genetics to help people who were sick. But after a time, I wanted to not just repair, I wanted to prevent. And I recognized there was power in genetics to identify risk before clinical symptoms and to help people not become patients. And so I left the traditional genetics environment, the traditional clinical environment, and came to Ancestry, where with a group of talented individuals, we have recently launched AncestryHealth, which I'm going to tell you a little bit more about today, and I'm excited about it because I believe this really will make an impact in preventative health. As you can see in this snapshot, it's focused on helping an individual understand their risks about a broad range of conditions, cardiovascular conditions, cancer, reproductive conditions, and wellness. I know this will make an impact in millions of people's lives, allowing them to not become patients. And why am I confident that we are going to succeed and we will do this at a scale that will make a real impact? Well, we are already the global leader in family history and consumer genomics. We already apply the latest advances in genetic science, artificial intelligence, and machine learning to bring meaningful insights to our customers. Family history has been the cornerstone of our industry, of our company. It's underpinned by the world's largest collection of digitized historical records. We have the largest family tree networks and over 3.4 million loyal subscribers. And our leadership in consumer genomics has earned us a member base of over 16 million customers. We already know how to engage people, and we already know how to have people understand more about their family history. We can add to that now more information about their health from their DNA, about their family health history, and additional information that we can bring from artificial intelligence and machine learning. These are all powerful synergies that work together. So why launch now? Well, consumers are ready. They tell us loud and clear they want to know more about what's inside of them, how they can take more action over their health. Second, the science is ready. Genomics has made leaps and bounds since Alta in 1984. There is a large and growing list of actionable insights and more coming all the time. And third, the technology is ready. At Alta, they imagined ways to sequence a handful of individuals. Today at Ancestry, we can sequence millions. AncestryHealth has been designed using the most comprehensive genetic screen available at a price and a scale that is unmatched in the market. And what does that really mean for people, for you? Well, it means that you will have access to affordable and comprehensive screening. You can take that and initiate that. You will get actionable insights, I promise you. Either you, family member, or it may be a stranger, because this is information that grows, but there will be access to insights that will help you proactively manage your health and prevent from becoming a patient. And we hear from our customers' stories now, testimonials of insights where they learned something about a risk, they took the next action that was recommended right there in the app on their phone, and they have alleviated symptoms that they've been carrying, and they've been helping their family members with the same. You will have access to education and genetic counseling resources. Who here knows what a genetic counselor even is? Didn't exist in 1984. These are healthcare professionals that are specifically trained in the communication and decision-making around genetic results. And we have a seamless handoff, something that you can provide to your physician that says, I learned this information, there was material here that I understood, but it also has created material that is for your physician, so they will have a way to help you manage if you choose to involve them in this care. There are two ways to get started, two levels. First, AncestryHealth Core. This is a first step affordable screen. It's based upon our traditional technology and the data that we already have. Again, it's a nice first step. It has a priority need to know number of conditions and a family health history tool. But our bigger focus is on Ancestry Health Plus. This is centered on an ongoing relationship with you, where you will get continual insights based upon both a more comprehensive genetic analysis as well as non-genetic markers of health, as well as a much more comprehensive tool to help you understand your family health history. We've made this product available to our current Ancestry DNA customers, and it will be broadly available in a few months. In Utah, we like to say life elevated. It's our state motto. But more than that, it's what we're working to achieve. We want to prevent what can be prevented and manage what can be managed and lift ourselves to this elevated life. So I want to thank you. I want to thank Utah. I want to thank Ancestry. It's a place that allows me to pursue my professional passion of bringing the value of the Human Genome Project to all of you, to all of the country. It's personalized medicine, it's preventative health, and it's now available at an affordable price and a scale, and I challenge you to take advantage of this opportunity. It will make a difference. And while you are at this conference, I hope you also get a chance to enjoy the beautiful surroundings of Utah as I do. Thank you.